वेलकम टू आर्यभट्ट सेंटर फॉर थ्योरेटिकल फिजिक्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल। व्हाट इज द इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल? इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल इज द सिस्टम ऑफ ए टू इक्वल इन मैग्नीट्यूड बट अनलाइक चार्जेस। इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल सिस्टम ऑफ टू इक्वल इन बट अनलाइक चार्जेस प्लस क्यू एंड माइनस क्यू सेपरेटेड बाय अ डिस्टेंस डिस्टेंस एल। माइनस क्यू प्लस क्यू सेपरेशन ऑफ दीज टू चार्जेस इज एल एंड वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट द पोटेंशियल ड्यू टू दिस डायपोल। This is the P. We have to find the potential at P due to this dipole. We consider that the distance of P from charge plus Q, positive charge, is R plus and this is R minus. And the angle here is theta. So we have to find the potential of the dipole field at point P. We can assume that the dipole itself is a point-like. It means the distance of this R is much greater than L. It means we can take this dipole as the point like this one, and we have to find the potential at P. Here angle theta, this is the R, and R, if R is much greater than L, then you can assume that this dipole is also a point like. So first of all we have to find the potential of the dipole at point P, and then we can find the electric field at point P. We are using polar coordinate E theta and this one E R. This is electric moment of the dipole P, small p. So the potential of the dipole at point P is simply phi is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by R plus minus Q divided by R minus. This is the dipole potential of the dipole at point P. This is the potential of the dipole field at point P, or we can write phi is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by R plus minus Q divided by R minus, or 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q R plus R minus R plus divided by R plus R minus. we have reduced the dipole as the point like. This is P, this is P. We have to find now electric field. We are taking a polar coordinate. This is angle theta, this is angle alpha, and this is angle theta. Now we know that R is much greater than L. It means R minus minus R plus equal to L cos theta. L cos theta. Here R plus R minus minus R plus is equal to L cos theta. And R plus R minus is nothing but a R square. Now we can simplify this term using these, which we will get 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q L cos theta divided by R square. This is the potential of the dipole field. And we know that electric moment of the dipole P is Q L. This is the electric moment of the dipole. It means phi will become 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P cos theta divided by R square. This is the potential of a dipole field at point P. And electric moment is P equal to Q L. And here electric moment equal to P equal to Q L, and here Q is greater than 0 and L is the vector directed at point P. Now we can calculate the what you call dipole field or electric field. We can calculate the dipole field or electric field E R and E theta along the unit vector theta and R, minus del phi y del R, and here minus del phi y del theta, and it will become 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 p cos theta divided by R cube, and here 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P sin theta divided by R square. This is the component of the dipole field. If this is the point P, this is dipole field E at point P, and if there is a component of this dipole field is E theta and E R, then we can find the dipole field component at ER and E theta, and this is R. Because L is much greater than the distance between two charges is much greater than, much smaller than this R, then we can treat the dipole as point like. So we have found ER and E theta. Now we can find the dipole field, which is E R square and E theta square, which will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught p by r cube root 1 plus 3 cos square theta. So this is the dipole field of a dipole. Dipole field of a dipole at point P. If theta is 0 and theta is pi by 2, then E parallel dipole will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 P divided by R cube, and E perpendicular will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P by R cube. So if theta is 0 and theta is pi by 2, so this is the electric field intensity. Electric field intensity. Electric field intensity of a dipole is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P by R cube root 1 plus 3 cos square theta. Imagine there is a electric field E, and here there is a dipole Q plus and Q minus, and distance between these two dipole is L. Then the electric force at Q plus is Q E plus and Q E minus. The resultant force acting on the dipole in electric field E is F is equal to Q E plus minus Q E minus, or Q E plus minus Q E minus. If we take the distance between Q plus and Q minus is too small, then we can write delta E is equal to E plus minus E minus equal to del E by del L L, or del E by del L L. Or we can write F is equal to Q del E by del L L. We know that Q L is equal to electric dipole, or P del E by del L. This is the force acting on the dipole. The force acting on the dipole. If dipole is in the electric field E, which is F is equal to electric dipole multiplied by the rate of change of electric field intensity. If F is in the x direction, then we can write F x is equal to P del E x by del L. This is the force acting on the dipole.